From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. A Chelsea Select woman accused of organizing a kickback scheme made her first court appearance Tuesday morning. Carol Swan is charged with aggravated forgery, improper compensation for services, and attempted theft. Prosecutors say she organized a kickback scheme involving the purchase of road sand for the town. People who live in Chelsea voted to pay for an investigation into allegations of misconduct at the town office after her arrest. Swan says she was conducting her own investigation of the town contracts.
Saying is my client had no intent by her actions to commit any crime or to deprive Chelsea of any of the money or to do any wrongdoings to the town of Chelsea. She's been a select person for 19 years, been elected 9 times, and has never done anything wrong or never been accused of any wrongdoing or done anything wrong to the town, and she wasn't about to start here.
Now, Swan is due back in Kennebec County Court at the end of June. That's unless a grand jury indicts her first. Now, starting this September, if your police catch you texting behind the wheel, it could cost you $100. Maine lawmakers have approved a bill that makes it illegal to text while driving. And unlike the current distracted driver law, it is now a primary offense, which means if police suspect that you're texting behind the wheel, well, they will have to pull you over. They have the power to pull you over, that is. While the fine can be a hefty deterrent, police hope drivers will simply become used to the law.
What we're hoping is that this discussion that's taken place in Augusta, that's taken place in the news media, that this will get people talking, it will get the operators on Maine's roads talking, and that they will voluntarily comply with the law.
Governor LePage still needs to sign the bill into law. 150 new jobs are headed to Lewiston, and the company moving in says it's planning on hiring another 100 on top of that. Carbonite, a company that provides online data backup for people throughout the world, plans on opening a technical support center in Lewiston. An exact location has not been chosen. The company's CEO says it chose Maine because of its proximity to Boston, where the company headquarters are. And they've been answering many of the customer service calls in India, but recently decided to change that.
You know, if customer support is going to be such a big part of our business, we need to be absolutely the best that we can be. So we made the decision about 6 months ago to repatriate all those jobs back to the U.S.
The CEO says he hopes to have the technical support center open by the end of the year and add more jobs once Carbonite fully transitions its other customer support jobs to the U.S. Now, the first kidney dialysis patient to compete in and complete an Ironman triathlon was in Portland today to encourage others who are dealing with kidney disease. Shad Ireland was diagnosed with kidney failure when he was just 10 years old and has spent nearly 3 decades dealing with related health problems and undergoing dialysis. In addition to the Ironman challenge, Ireland has competed in numerous events and even biked across the country to raise awareness. He hopes his story will inspire others to continue living their lives despite their affliction. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. We'll be right back.